Let's look at a concrete example. This graph shows the voltage transfer characteristic for a particular device, and we're wondering if we can use this device as a combinational inverter. In other words, can we pick values for the voltage thresholds VOL, VIL, VIH, and VOH so that the shown VTC meets the constraints imposed on a combinational device? An inverter outputs a digital 1 when its input is a digital 0, and vice versa. In fact, this device does produce a high output voltage when its input voltage is low, so there's a chance this will work out. The lowest output voltage produced by the device is 0.5 volts. So if the device is to produce a legal digital output of 0, we have to choose VOL to be at least 0.5 volts. We want the inverter to produce a valid digital 0 whenever its input is a valid digital 1. Looking at the VTC, we see that if the input is higher than 3 volts, the output will be less than or equal to VOL. So let's set VIH to 3 volts. We could set it to a higher value than 3 volts, but we'll make it as low as possible to leave room for a generous high noise margin. That takes care of 2 of the 4 signal thresholds, VOL and VIH. The other 2 thresholds are related to these 2 by the noise margin N, as shown by these 2 equations. Can we find a value for N such that Vout is greater than or equal to VOH when Vin is less than or equal to VIL? If we choose N as 0.5 volts, then the formulas tell us that VIL is 1 volt and VOH is 3.5 volts. Plotting these thresholds on the graph and adding the forbidden regions, we see that happily the VTC is, in fact, legal. So we can use this device as a combinational inverter if we use the signaling specifications with VOL as 0.5 volt, VIL is 1 volt, VIH is 3 volts, and VOH is 3.5 volts. We're good to go.